Teacher talking sports, what it does would do how we live. And if you've ever been to a professional sports game, you know how much it can cost if you're buying food and drink at the stadium. Often outprices the amount of even the tickets. If you bring your family, good luck. You might be paying a week's salary at the game just on food and drink. But you want to at least know that the food is high quality, that it's clean. Well, let's take a look at this article here via CBS Sports. Andrew Julian, dead rodents found at Jaguars TIAA Bank Field concession stands during inspection. Not something you want to hear if you've recently been to a Jaguars game. So as it mentions, according to a report by Action News Jax, a November 6 concession stand health inspection found dead rodents and more than 150 incidents of rodent droppings among 129 health violations at the Jags home stadium. Investigators also found 7 concession stands operating with expired licenses. Delaware North is a concession company that operates food service at the stadium and issued this statement, Action News Jax. Delaware North follows the highest standards in food service and has strict policies to ensure compliance with all applicable food safety standards and regulations. A team of health inspectors spent the day on November 6th inspecting the food service locations during a live event with more than 62,000 fans. Our managers worked closely with the health inspectors during the visit, and most of the violations identified were rectified immediately or within 24 hours. Furthermore, we are working to resolve the clerical error that led to a lapse in licenses for 2 of our concession stands. The other locations listed in the report as having licenses lapsed were not in operation at the time of inspection. Well, that message by Delaware North, that statement didn't even mention the rats, because they probably know how disgusting that is. I'm kind of surprising that this didn't come out last year when it seemed like everything went wrong with the Jaguars, especially with Urban Meyer as their head coach. This year, they were at least improved. Somehow 3-7, but have actually outscored their opponents on the season, but they're on a bye week this week. It'll be interesting to see next week. They do play at home against Baltimore. Will a story like this affect their attendance? I mean, they're out of the playoff hunt for the most part, so that might affect it too, but will this affect it even more, where people are on the fence of maybe going to the game, and now that they know that they have been citations against their concession stands, rat droppings, dead rats, they may think twice about going. But let me know what you think about this. Don't forget to subscribe. Tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend to subscribe. Like the video, share the video, hit the bell for notifications. I'm out.